वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक 6M सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस। माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। सो वी आर आवर टॉपिक इज इवेल्युएटिंग एंड चूजिंग द बेस्ट हाइपोथेसिस। सो वी ऑलरेडी कवर्ड सम टॉपिक्स, सो गो टू आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक। ओके, we have covered last time model selection, and now we from error rates to loss and then regularization. So so far we have been trying to minimize error rate, so this is clearly better than maximizing error rate. And consider the problem of classifying emails messages as spam or non-spam. It is worse to classify non-spam as spam, and then to classify spam as non-spam. So a classifier with 1% error rate, where almost all the zeros were classifying spam or as non-spam, would be better than a classifier with only 0.5% error rate. If most of those errors were classifying non-spam as spam, then decision makers should maximize expected utility, and utility is what learners should maximize as well. So we are already seen the example of spam and non-spam earlier. So let's start with this error rate. So in machine learning, it is traditional to express utilities by means of a loss function. So the loss function L x comma y comma cap y, so is defined as the amount of utility lost by predicting hx is equal to cap y. When the correct answer is fx is equal to y, then l x comma y comma cap y is equal to utility result of using y given an input x minus utility results of using cap y given an input x. So you can see here this, then this is the most general formulation of the loss function, and often a simplified version is used, just l y comma cap y, and that is independent of x. And so we will use the simplified version for the rest of this discussion, and which means we can't say that it is worse to misclassify a letter from mom than it is to misclassify a letter from our annoying cousin. But we can say it is 10 times worse to classify non-spam as spam than vice versa. So here is L spam comma no spam. So here is y is equal to spam and cap y is equal to no spam is equal to 1, and l no spam comma spam is equal to 10. So note that l y comma y is always 0, and by definition there is no loss when you guess exactly right. And for a function with discrete outputs, we can enumerate a loss value for each possible misclassification. And but we can't enumerate all the possibilities for real valued data. If fx is 137.035999, so we would be fairly happy with hx is equal to 137.036, but just it is not so good. And in general, small errors are better than large ones, and two functions that implement that idea are the absolute value of the difference, and called the L1 loss, so and the square of the difference called the L2 loss. So if we are content with the idea of minimizing error rate, we can use the L0 by 1 loss function, which has a loss of 1 for an incorrect answer and is appropriate for discrete value output. So here is absolute value loss L1 y comma cap y is equal to mod y minus cap y, and squared error loss means L2 y comma cap y is equal to y minus cap y square and 0 by 1 loss L 0 by 1 y comma y cap y is equal to 0 if y is equal to cap y else 1. So the learning agent can theoretically maximize its okay, here is the some mistakes, but we will do it correct here in short time. 1 minute. Okay, there are some problems because it's moving. 1 minute. Okay, that's okay now. So the learning agent can theoretically maximize its expected utility by choosing the hypothesis that minimizes expected loss over all input output pairs. It will see, and it is meaningless to talk about the expectation without defining a prior probability distribution P x comma y over example, and let E be the set of all possible input output example. So then the expected generalization loss for a hypothesis H with respect to loss function L is, here you can see general loss L and H is equal to summation of L y comma hx and into probability our prior probability distribution x comma y, and where x y belongs to E, and the best hypothesis H star is the one with the minimum expected generalization loss. So H star is equal to arg mean general loss L H, and H belongs to H. So you can see here, and because probability x comma y is not known, so the learning agent can only estimate generalization loss with empirical loss on a set of example here. So here you can see the example loss, empirical loss, sorry, L comma E H is equal to 1 by N summation L y comma hx, and where x y belongs to E, and the estimated best hypothesis H star is then one with minimum empirical loss. So H star is equal to arg mean empirical loss L comma E H, and H belongs to H. So here there are four reasons why H cap H star may, sorry, here, okay, I missed that. The estimated best hypothesis cap H star is then one with minimum empirical loss. So cap H star is equal to arg mean and empirical loss L E comma E H. So that's the so H star with cap, and there are four reasons why cap H star may differ from the true function F, and unreliability variance, so noise and computational complexity. And the first F may not be realizable, may not be in H, or may be present in such a way that other hypotheses are preferred. So second, a learning algorithm will return different hypotheses for different sets of examples. Even if those sets are drawn from the same true function F, and those hypotheses will make different prediction on new examples, and the higher the variance among the prediction, the higher the probability of significant error. So not that even when the problem is realizable and there will still be random variance, but that variance decreases towards zero as the number of training examples increases. And third, F may be non-deterministic or noisy, so it may return different values for fx each time x occurs, and by definition noise cannot be predicted In many cases, it rises because the observed value, observed level Y are the result of attributes of the environment not listed in X. And finally, when H is complex, it can be computationally intractable to systematically search the whole hypothesis space. So the best we can do is a local search like hill climbing and climbing or greedy search that explore only part of the space, and that gives us an approximation error. In combining the sources of error, we are left with an estimation for an approximation of the true function f. So traditional method in statistics, the early years of the machine learning concentrated on small scale learning, and where the number of training examples range from dozen to the low thousands. Here the generalization error mostly comes from the approximation errors of not having the true F in the hypothesis space, and from estimation error of not having enough training examples to limit variance. So in recent years there has been more emphasis on large scale learning, often with millions of examples, and here the generalization errors is dominated by limits of computations. There is enough data and rich enough model that we could find an edge that is very close to the true F, but the computation to find is too complex, so we settle for a suboptimal approximation. So that's all about error rate to loss. And then next, regularization, last topics for discussion. Already we saw how to model selection with cross validation on model size. So an alternative approach is to search for an hypothesis that directly minimize the weighted sum of empirical loss and the complexity of the hypothesis. So we can we call the total cost cost H is equal to empirical loss H plus lambda complexity H, and here is cap H star is equal to arg mean cost H. So here lambda is a parameter, a positive number that serves as a conversion rate between loss and hypothesis complexity, and this approach combines loss and complexity into one metric, allowing us to find the best hypothesis all at once. And we still need to do a cross validation search to find the hypothesis that generalizes best, but this time it is with different value of lambda rather than size. So we select the value of lambda that gives us the best validation set score, and this process of explicitly parallelizing complex hypotheses is called regularization. So not that the cost function requires us to make two choices, the loss function and the complexity measure, which is called a regularization function, and this the choice of regularization function depends on the hypothesis space. So for example, a good regularization function for polynomials is the sum of the square of the coefficients, and keep the sum small would guide us away from the weakly polynomials. So as you can see here, I think here not, okay, sorry, here we can see, okay, we have a bigger, we have to go back and more back, okay, here in figure B and C, and another way to simplify it, okay, model okay, here we will come to our topic, regularization. Okay, so another way to simplify model is to reduce the dimensions that the model works with. A process of feature selection can be performed to discard attributes that appear to be irrelevant, and chi-square pruning is a kind of feature selection. So already we have discussed about chi-square in our previous video, and it is in fact possible to have the empirical loss and the complexity measured on the same scale and without the conversation factor lambda. convergence factor lambda, they can both be measured in bits. And first encode the hypothesis as a Turing machine program and count the number of bits. Then count the number of bits required to encode the data, where a correctly predicted example costs 0 bits and the cost of an incorrectly predicted example depends on how large the error is. So minimum description length, or in short MDAL hypothesis, minimizes the total number of bits required. This works well in the limit, but for smaller problem there is a difficulty in that the choice of encoding for the program. So for example, how best to encode a decision tree as a bit string, so affects the outcomes. And we can describe a probabilistic interpretation of the MDL approach by this way. So that's all about regularization. So now the session ends here. Thank you.